In much of my prior work, particularly the quarter-life period, I explored the use of multiple panels to convey a single unit of continuous ideas. I found myself drawn to this method because it was so effective in displaying an entire narrative, whereas with just a single canvas, you're more likely to capture just one moment or risk cramming too much information onto one space. After completing the romance works, I return to this technique once again. With each series, I can begin with a solitary idea and build upon it slowly, layer by layer. Each piece is a part of the puzzle, important unto itself, but together they create a full, complete understanding. In a world that grows ever more complex, I need a beginning, middle, and ending in all of my work, whether it be a close study of the texture and lighting of flowers, like the Valentine Lily study, a tale of love and loss, like the miniature panels of the One series, a satirical political commentary of the times, as in the currency exchange books, or even a panoramic landscape like the Beam Commission triptych. I aspire to take the casual observer on a journey, rather than just dropping them in the middle of nowhere and leaving them there to fend for themselves visually. I want them to know the origins and the outcome of what they are looking at, or at least have some inkling or curiosity of them, so that they can actually connect with the work on a personal level. Someone once asked me, "How do I know when I'm finished with a painting?" The short answer is, when it feels right, when I feel like nothing more can be done with it. The long answer is, a painting is never really done, because the story within it presumably continues on infinitely, and it changes each time you come back to it, loaded with a new perspective, a new vision or idea. At best, I can walk away from canvas with some sense of closure, with the feeling that a story has been conveyed fully with a start and a finish point, that there has been a complete message exchanged between painter and viewer.